Hi, I'm Ben Franklin, Parliamentary Secretary for Northern New South Wales. And it's great to have my mate Kev Anderson, the Parliamentary Secretary for Roads and Maritime, here in Ballina today. Kev, what are we doing here?
Yeah, Ben, really important. Saving our species with koalas. We're looking at revegetation as well as those important koala corridors. And part of Maritime, we're going to upgrade the Brunswick Heads boat ramp. Yep. That's where accidents happen when you're launching, as well as making sure there's plenty of safe areas to park.
That's it. You love your boats, don't you?
I love my boats.
Yeah. And what else?
One thing really important I know you've been working very hard on.
That's it. Really excited about the Pacific Highway upgrade. We're actually looking today at the second longest bridge. Out of 150 bridges we're doing on the Pacific Highway upgrade, the second longest one at Broadwater. We're going to look at that today. It's going to be a great day, Kev.
Let's get on with that.
The new Pacific Highway is an incredible piece of infrastructure that's going to benefit everyone across our region, across the country. But in our area, we care passionately about preserving our local environment as well, and that means protecting our koalas. Kev, what have we seen today in terms of what we're doing to achieve that?
What we've installed here is a koala grid, which works exactly the same as a cattle grid. The animals will come up to the edge of it, realize they can't get across, and find another way around, which protects them and keeps them in a safe environment from crossing highways. So who would have thought that an age-old cattle grid could be repurposed for a koala grid? It's fantastic technology. I want to thank the engineers from RMS for coming up with this sort of suggestion and idea. It's best practice, there's no doubt about that, and it is about looking after our species and ultimately saving them.
We've got 8 of these grids which are being rolled out across our region, and that along with the fencing means that there's literally no fatalities at these areas because of what we're doing. It's just incredibly exciting. We're protecting our environment, we're protecting our koalas, and we're building one of the best highways in the world at exactly the same time. It's a good day, Kev.
Absolutely unbelievable.
Well, Kev, it's great to be here at Brunswick Heads in the beautiful electorate of Ballina to announce a wonderful project under the Boating Now program. What do you got for us today?
Yeah, really pleased to say, Ben, that we are here to announce $500,000 to upgrade the Brunswick Heads boat ramp. It is an important part of getting boats in and out of the water. This is where accidents do happen, sadly, so we need to make them as safe as possible, not only when you're launching, but also when you're retrieving, and then to have a safe place where you can park your cars and your trailers and know that it's all going to be there when you come off the water at the end of the day.
We love the Brunswick River. It's a beautiful environmental part of this particular part of the community. We love it. And it's so good that we're going to have our boaties now come in and out in safety. But it's not just about Brunswick. We've got some other things to announce today too.
Absolutely. Fisheries Creek we've upgraded. We've also upgraded Keith Hall. A significant amount of money, you know. We're talking about out of the Boating Now program, nearly $1 million. We want to continue to invest in our waterways, and it's only through your strong advocacy and you pushing hard that this happens, Ben.
$1 million almost for our community, for our boaties. It's a great day and we're going to keep supporting them. Thanks to the New South Wales Government.
Let's go fishing.
Kevy, it's great to be on the Burns Point Ferry. We're heading over to South Ballina. This is a real icon of the local Ballina region. We've had this going for decades. It's run by the council and it just goes back and forth across the river, done in a really, really great way. And we're about to drive off. You know, the driver actually sleeps on the ferry in the middle of the river overnight when they stop running it, which is a pretty committed job. Anyway, I better let you focus on this, but it's a... We're now off to Keith Hall to go to have a look at another boat ramp that we've upgraded. Great day. Well, Kevy, here we are at the end of Keith Hall Lane in South Ballina. Once again, looking at a great new outcome from the Boating Now program. We've got $225,000 for a new pontoon, new boat ramp, trailer parking. It's great news. Can you tell us more about it?
Yeah, the beauty about this one is that it's all about safety. We're getting a lot of tidal movement, you get a lot of wash and a lot of wind, and you need an area that is protected to be able to launch your boat and also retrieve. So the floating pontoon does that. In addition to that, it rises and falls with the tide, which prevents people from getting their boats jammed under a wharf or a pontoon and increases the safety component of it. So it's a win-win all round.
It's great. We're supporting boaties in our community, and this is just another way of showing it in practice today.
Absolutely.
The upgrade of the Pacific Highway is a game changer for New South Wales, and today I'm here with Kevin Anderson looking at the final section, the last 155 kilometres, and we're looking at the bridge over the Richmond River at Broadwater. Kevy, this is an amazing, amazing feat.
Yeah, look, it is. It's an engineering piece of excellence, no doubt about it, when you talk about what we're doing here on the coast in northern New South Wales. It is about improved safety. It is about driving that road toll down to zero. And the way we do that is improve our roads. And coming through here many years ago, it was decided to build a bridge. We're building a bridge, and eventually we're going to get over it, and it's going to be an absolute cracker.
Almost 1 kilometre long, this is an extraordinary piece of engineering marvel. It's the second longest bridge of 170 throughout regional New South Wales on the Pacific Highway, and it's going to be open in March 2020 on time and on budget.